So you just want to flip the unit over and loosen up all the screws in the bottom cover. Now you can take your spudger and pop the bottom cover off. Once the bottom cover is off, the first thing you want to do inside of here is disconnect the battery cable from the motherboard. This just helps prevent any shortages with the motherboard or the LCD. Once the battery has been disconnected, you want to take out all of the screws that are holding the motherboard in. Now that the screws that are holding the motherboard in are out, you can start disconnecting all of the cables. So you can disconnect the LCD cable. The speakers. The keyboard cable, the touchpad cable. There are two USB ribbons and the Wi-Fi card. Now that everything is disconnected, you just want to lift up on the unit just a little bit, so that this hinge lifts up so that you can easily access the motherboard. You might also need to lift up on the battery to get the motherboard out from underneath, and then carefully remove it. Now you can take your new motherboard and carefully put it back into place, being careful of the ports on the side. To put it back in, you might have to lift up on the battery just very slightly to get it underneath of there. Once it is back into place, you can put this hinge back down and start reconnecting all of the cables. So you can reconnect the LCD cable. The speakers, the keyboard ribbon, you don't want to reconnect the battery just yet. So you can move over here and reconnect the touchpad ribbon. You can reconnect the two USB ribbons. Thank you. and you can reconnect the Wi-Fi card. Now that everything is reconnected except for the battery, you can go back and put all of the screws back in to hold the motherboard down. Now that we are ready to put the bottom cover back on, now you can reconnect the battery. You can pop your bottom cover back on. And tighten the screws. To make sure that the replacement was successful, you can plug the unit in. And then you can open it up. And as long as the screen comes on, then that means the replacement was successful. Now I'm going to unplug it while it is still on to make sure that the battery is working properly. And if you unplug it and it is still on, then that means that was successful as well. So you can shut the unit off and close it.